Today we're going to discuss a scoliosis, and I think we should divide scoliosis up. Today we're only going to discuss people who have no other diseases. They don't have cerebral palsy. They don't have arthrogryposis. They don't have spina bifida. They just were diagnosed with scoliosis. And who are these people? Well, usually they're women, the young girls, somewhere between the ages of 10 and 14, usually before they get their period, and they're diagnosed with scoliosis. It can happen in boys as well, but often it's more severe in girls. And scoliosis just means you have a curve in your back. That's all that means. We don't know the reason. We don't understand the reason. And I'll be doing it later times discussing for people who have other reasons for it. And that'll be a specific conversation. But for today, let's just discuss what happens if you went to your doctor and they said you have a curve in your back. Well, the first thing you have to know is you can have a curve in your back to the side, like an S, and that's called scoliosis, or a C, like scoliosis. Or you can be bent forward, like hunchbacked, and that's called kyphosis. And those are two different things. And again, I'm going to be limiting the talk just to scoliosis. So scoliosis is measured in degrees in angles, like we learned in geometry. You could have 0 degrees, which means you have a straight spine. You could have a 10-degree curve, which means you have a very small curve. 20-degree curve, you have a moderate curve. 30-degree curve, more moderate. And then once you get above 40 degrees, you have a severe curve. And I always hear people saying percent. There's no percent curve. It's just number of degrees of angulation. So we just measure the angles of the curve of your back done on x-ray. We can also do it on your exam when we examine you. So then how do we evaluate you? So first thing we do is we examine you. We take a history. Does your mother have it? Did your grandmother have it? Does your aunt have it? Usually runs in families. Does your sister have it? Does your brother have it? Then we ask, does it hurt you? It can hurt a little bit, but it shouldn't hurt a lot. It shouldn't wake you up at night. You shouldn't have any skin changes over your back. You shouldn't feel any numbness or tingling. And if you do, then oftentimes you'll fit into a different category, and we'll get MRIs and something like that. But usually we can get x-rays, and today x-ray can be done with very minimal radiation, unlike in the past. And we're getting onto newer and newer ways of doing this with very, very small amounts of radiation. And we look at your scoliosis, and we see the number of degrees that you have. And then we determine a treatment plan. If it's very low, then we say we'll just observe you, maybe see you in 4 to 6 months. If it's getting higher, then if you're very young and you have a lot of growth left, then you use that bad word called bracing, because no kid wants to wear a brace. Well, sometimes a bracing can just be done at night. Sometimes the bracing has to be done during the day, and we try to figure out how you can handle that. And sometimes if you can't handle it, we can say, well, perhaps you want an internal brace, and we talk about stapling. And that's something I won't really discuss today, but there are ways of using internal bracing and even surgery to do that. The results are certainly not certain, but it's a way of not having to wear a brace for many years. Is there where you can only wear your brace at night? Perhaps, and we can discuss that too, if I saw you and you said you needed a brace. So we try to take the whole child into perspective. We speak to the parents. Can the child tolerate wearing a brace? I mean, we don't want to ruin someone's body image by wearing a brace. Does the brace work? Well, we think so. It doesn't work all the time, but hopefully it'll delay or stop the progression of the curve. When do you talk about surgery? Usually over 50 degrees. The scoliosis is over 50 degrees. And we try to prevent it from being over 40 degrees when you reach maturity, because usually scoliosis gets worse when you're young, when you're growing. The growth spurts increase the scoliosis. So that's basically what scoliosis is. The surgery today, completely different than it used to be. Even when I was training, we had people in casts and braces and things like that that we don't use anymore. Now you're out of bed right away, back in school in a few weeks, and really your life, you can do all the sports as soon as you're able to. So really, it's really changed. Are there risks behind scoliosis surgery? There are certainly risks, but I think we've minimized them, and it's really become pretty tried and true how we take care of this. Doesn't mean you should have surgery. It means we should try to avoid it if we can, but sometimes we can't avoid it. And we can discuss, and as I make these, and you can see from other tapes, specifically about surgery for scoliosis, specifically about what happens if your child's very young, 3 years old, 4 years old, newborn with scoliosis. Different treatment, different discussion. But I think for the teenager, for the young preteen, 12-year-old, that's basically scoliosis. The treatment is from nothing, from 0 to 30 degrees. Then all of a sudden we're talking about bracing for the young child, perhaps surgery for if this really progresses. And I think that basically is scoliosis in a nutshell.